Hi, it's Larry Herb, Xbox Live's Major Nelson. Welcome to the show. We're getting ready to do the podcast again. Another week, another great show, and another chance for me to hit the magic button and bring Jeff in. There you go. Hi, Jeff.
Look, don't make promises you can't keep. It's not a great show until the end, and we look back and go, that was average at best.
I want to say it's, I want to set the bar. I want to set the bar. But it's
good
to see.
We're going to fake it till we make it.
You haven't seen, you know, I haven't seen you in a week. You didn't know, I got a haircut.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
That, so. You needed it.
I know. Everybody, my entire house, my wife and daughter are like, go get a haircut.
Yeah, that's good. I hope you were safe. And did you do it at home? Did you do a home haircut?
No. I went to a hair place. My barber has a, or hairstyle, whatever they call them now. You know, I had the mask. They had the mask.
It's still called a barber, Larry.
The face, covering the whole thing.
Salon.
So it was, Anyway, hi.
Hi. What's going on? I'm shut in a room. There's thunder and lightning, which never happens here. I've got a light in my face. I'm a little lost.
You got me
here.
And your computer, which we you don't have.
There we go.
You and I talk frequently, but we don't do video calls all the time. You're very standoffish about that.
Yeah. It's because usually I'm like eating on the call, or I'm like drifting. I have a short attention span. Like in person meetings, I can focus in on you. But doing like Skype and Zoom calls and Teams calls all day, it's just, you know, I tend to drift. A lot of times I'm sitting here stretching. I'm like touching my toes or skipping around in the room. Oh, yeah. I'm like bouncing around in the room. Nobody needs to see that. Look like an idiot.
All right. Well, yeah. Workouts? Maybe like, you know, do our.
Yeah, I got my Ring Fit back here and I'm like, you know, doing the thing. Look at me. What a COVID body.
Just be
this
careful
is.
What you're doing and make sure you know when the camera's on and when it's not. That's all I'm asking.
That's lessons that many people seem to continue to be learning.
By the way, I see what you have in the back. What do you have? What are you playing in the back there?
That was the Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War. Longest name for a title. Yep. That's okay. Beta that wrapped up. I don't think I can go past the title screen right now because the beta wrapped up.
Right.
But I'm not the biggest Call of Duty devotee. I play the campaigns and I love the campaigns. I don't think I've really gotten into like a multiplayer suite of and they provide you a ton of stuff. I sample them all. I play two matches each year and then I'm like, I'm terrible at this and I move on. For whatever reason, I fired up the Cold War beta. They made it open to everybody. I had cross play and all kinds of stuff. And I was playing with a buddy of mine on PC, you know, Clem down in San Francisco. He walked me through it. Had a heck of a time. I really, really liked it. And I think that I'm just, whether it's been, you know, honing my reflexes on Apex or whatever, I think I'm going to play a bunch of this.
We played the other night. It was you, me, Will, and somebody, I thought it was somebody else too.
There was somebody else. I don't remember who, but it doesn't
here we
matter.
Are. Oh, we had fun. Yeah. We had fun. There was all sorts of different modes to check out. So looking forward to check that out.
For a beta, they threw a ton at you.
Yeah, there was a lot going on.
Kill confirmed. There was a mode that was kind of like a mini battle royale called Fallout or Dirty Bomb.
Dirty Bomb.
There was Team Deathmatch. There was the, you know, Territories, King of the Hill, whatever it's called. There was a lot here. And, you know, some modes we didn't do so well in, and some modes we did pretty darn good in.
Yeah,
kudos to them. The campaign does look really interesting. With like sort of that 80s Iran-Contra stuff going on. Stuff that was happening when I was a kid and didn't know what it meant. I guess I'm going to learn through a Call of Duty. Look, we're all learning in interesting ways. So why not learn 80s American history through a first-person shooter? I'm fine with it.
Well, you know, you're learning 80s American history, which I studied and frankly lived because I'm just a little bit older than you. But, you know, one thing that I... I'm studying that I haven't really had a chance to flex is my farmer muscle.
But you have agrarian roots, Larry. So let's talk about this game because we've both been playing it.
It's so what I'm talking about is it's a game called Shotgun Farmer. And what happened was, let me back up a little bit because I need to do this. Can I set it up?
Please. This is you. Let's do it.
So last Saturday, I'm ready to play. Jeff and I usually play Apex. It's kind of our go-to, kind of relaxing.
Got our win last night, but yes, not to derail.
So I'm all ready to go, and I say, "Oh, okay, let me join your party." I join your party, and you're like, "Okay, we're just finishing up. Everyone's joining me. I'll catch up with you." 2 hours later,
Still,
you're really gonna. Oh, I didn't realize we were gonna do this setup.
So I realize I'm like, okay, well, maybe he's not coming. So I was looking and I was reading about this game called Shotgun Farmers, and I was like, okay, I'll check it out. And I download it and start. I did the tutorial because there's some bots, and I was like, okay, this is actually a lot of fun. So I was tweeting about it, and I told you, I'm like, Jeff, you know, if you want to play with me again, we should try Shotgun Farmers ever. And he's like, what are you talking about? And I sent you a link to the game. And so why don't you tell your side of the story?
Yeah. I was like, I guess. And this game, it kind of looks like Garden Warfare, but with like stick figures. Like your gun is your default gun that you spawn in with is a corn shotgun that shoots corn kernels.
Right.
And every shot that you miss, the corn kernels go into the ground and could be scooped up as ammo. It's like, it's.
I mean, look.
There you go. You're planning, you know, so you're, you're beating your swords into plowshares, Larry.
Well, and look, and what's interesting, you can actually harvest the shotgun. And,
yeah.
And, but what's, but the problem is this, here's the tip that you told me. Go ahead and tell the audience.
Yeah. So like, as the match goes on, the plant gets bigger and bigger, and the bigger it is, the more ammo you have in it. So, right. So you sort of a trade-off. Do I let this thing continue to grow to get multiple shots? Because you can't switch weapons. You get what you have.
Right.
And someone else might pick it up.
And a shovel.
Exactly. And a shovel. And the shovel is actually lethal. We ended up, we must have played this game for 2 hours. The achievements were rolling in. We were pretty darn good at it. And, you know, and isn't this game like, just like pretty darn inexpensive, right?
I'd have to look at the watermelon gun.
So yeah, there's an asparagus sniper rifle.
So I don't know.
Logic has no place in this conversation. The reality is, though, it's a surprisingly fun game.
There was deathmatch. There was the hold the chicken. Is that what it was called?
Yeah. It was like capture the flag, right. But you had to capture the pig, ride the pig
very slowly back to your base.
And then this one, which was like griff ball or something, where you had to hold a chicken, and the chicken's squawking at you, and you're just running and trying not to be, you
know. Oh, those are the days.
This is a game that the whole time you kind of want to make fun of it, but you're laughing.
And you know what? Really, it's time. Okay, because it makes fun of itself.
It's $9.99. I'll tell you what, time to getting into a match was super quick. We were matching immediately. I think it's 4v4, maybe 5v. Yeah, up to 5v5, depending on the mode. And you know what? Kind of fun. It's something interesting to try out on a weekend with some friends. And for your I felt like I got my $10 investment back in space.
I'm looking at it right now on it's been available on Steam for quite some time. It just came to Xbox about a month ago. Okay. So it is it's multiplayer competitive shooter that's farm themed and just fun. So that's all I'm going to say.
There I was pleasantly surprised because we just kept saying, you want to get another one? And I was like, because I felt like we were going to jump into something else. We actually might have jumped back into the Cold War beta.
I could tell you were humoring me, right?
At the start, I was like, you know what, Larry, for all you, right. Because I sold you out.
You blew me off on Saturday night. I'll play this with you.
I'll play this game. And then it was just like, you want to get another one? I will do one more. One more.
That's the sign of a great game, right? One more round.
Indeed.
Anyway, so Shotgun Farm. I'm playing that. It's Apex. I don't know what else I'm playing. I think that's pretty much it. I mean, it's been a busy week. We're almost just a little bit over 2 weeks, 2.5 weeks almost, launching Xbox. Do I have
it? Felt like just yesterday we revealed the Series X at the Game Awards, and somehow we're closer to the next Game Awards.
Was that the last time publicly that you? We're in like a big event.
I didn't go. Okay. I was going to go, and I ended up at the last minute staying home. I can't remember why, and watching from home. And of course, it was fun to watch from home. But it would have been great to be in the.
I think you had to watch a rom com with your wife or something, right?
I mean, maybe it was a Saturday night. You know, I can't spend every Saturday night. That 48 hour December fiance thing Keeling.
Or whatever it was.
Oh, the 90 day fiance? That's on Sundays, Larry. Come on, get with the program. What else? I'm just trying to see what else. Oh, I beat Halo ODST this weekend.
Well done.
I had never done it, and then immediately found out that the Halo team announced that 343, that they're going to be enhancing the Master Chief Collection, optimizing it for Series X. So, but look, ODST came out 10 years ago.
Yeah.
I was way behind, having not finished it. It was one of two games I had not completed. I finished Reach, which Reach is still, I think, my favorite now. You know, but I hadn't played through it. So I'll just go play through it. And I beat it, and I still have Halo 4. That's my last one. But now that I know that the team's going to be optimizing it, by the end of this year, I think was the date. Then I will hold off and I'll finish Halo 4 over Christmas. And I think that'll be good.
I'm okay with that.
Yeah. Why not?
I'm okay with that. You know, so we talked about Xbox Series X and X and S going on sale. Within a little bit over 2 weeks, but there's a lot of titles that are coming out that are going to be available at launch, optimized. Do you have that list? I'm kind of setting you up here.
I can bring that up. So there's 30 games that we'd announced on a blog post.
Let's be clear. This is in addition to the hundreds, nay thousands available thousands for backwards compatibility. So you've got a lot to play at launch. And let's be clear, all your save games that you played on Xbox One or Xbox 360 or not the original Xbox, but that go far back, they're going to come with you. You don't have to do anything. You don't have to look at a list and go, gee, does this one work? Or go to the community, go to Reddit and go, gee, does this work? We test them all for you to give you the optimal, cleanest experience. And that's our back compat team is second to none. I will put them up against anybody in the world.
I think they're kind of running unopposed in a way, but yes.
Anyway, do you have that list available?
I'm getting there. We have too many posts, by the way, that we put up there. All right. Is this it? Nope, it's not. You put me on.
I'm sorry. I'm kind of putting you on the spot, exactly as I said, because this is something that's really interesting in that, in that we've got all these titles coming up. We've got Assassin's Creed coming out.
I got it.
We've got Watch Dogs. Well, why don't you quickly tick through the list? Because if you can, maybe it's not even quickly.
Let me
go
drag
ahead.
That over here so you don't have to see the side of my head. So, so this is a combination. These are the day one Xbox Series X and Xbox Series S optimized titles. Some of these games, you can play them now and they will be optimized. Some of these games are coming out that day. Assassin's Creed Valhalla is a great example of that. Bright Memory 1.0, Dirt 5, let's see, Gears Tactics. We're going to have an interview with Gears Tactics later today. Yakuza Like a Dragon. Tetris Effect Connected. Those are games that are coming out on day one that'll be brand new games. However, you may own certain other games that you're going to find look better than ever. Borderlands 3 is a good example. Uh-huh. Dead by Daylight. Forza Horizon 4, which, let me tell you, I've seen it running on Xbox Series X, and it blew my mind.
As I have.
Gears 5. Manifold Garden. This is a game that I've been really enjoying. I've been playing through it. If you like The Witness, I know I've talked about it before. Definitely take a look at this. If you start playing it now on Xbox One, if and when you graduate to an Xbox Series S or an Xbox Series X, comes with you and it'll be enhanced. It'll load faster than ever. It'll look better than ever. World Rally Championship 9, Warhammer Chaos Bane, The Tourist. There's 30 games here. Sea of Thieves. I really want to see what Sea of Thieves look like, optimized for Xbox Series X. NBA 2K21. We've seen footage of this. Mind-blowing. And the NBA 2K series, I feel like on the 360 generation, then moving on to Xbox One. And now that's always like the first game I pop in there to blow people's mind. If people come over that aren't hardcore gamers, but they've been hearing about it, I'm like, wait till you take a look at this. So I cannot wait to be able to play that one at home. There's other games coming down the line. I know FIFA is going to be optimizing for Xbox Series X as well. I don't know the date on it, but I do know that I love FIFA, and I can't wait to see what that looks like.
Are you playing with your brother, by the way? You usually play it with your brother.
Yeah. I get it. If I go online, I'm just going to get my butt kicked. Oh, wait, he kicks my butt too. So I don't know. Maybe I should be doing that. But yeah, it's, you know, we always, that's sort of our couch co-op, you know, and I punch him when he scores. That's,
did I tell you that I've got these, I've got these faux consoles that we sent some people.
Yeah. Know,
this and the Xbox Series, the S one, but I've got both of them here. Yep. And these are not real. These are just the plastic shells. But it's funny. I was some neighborhood kids of mine that obviously live here around here. They watch the podcast. Like, hey, can we see it? So I had to bring these out to the front porch, and I kind of let them look at these, and they're like, oh, this is so cool. You know, they're looking at the play. It was just this bizarre moment where the neighborhood kids wanted to take a look at the new consoles. And
yeah.
One guy's, can I borrow it? I want to go see if it's, you know, if it's going to fit in my entertainment center. And I'm like, well, you just need to go to Xbox.com. They have a paper version you can cut out and build it yourself.
Well, there's that. And I think I feel like I've seen an augmented reality one you can look at on your phone and sort of position it there.
Right. Yeah. Use your phone to position there. So anyway, yeah, these are the faux ones. And as you can see, it says prototype, not for sale.
Yes. Well, I mean, you can't plug anything in there. It's covered up. But anyway, now you know what it looks like. You don't have to wait too much longer.
Just about 2 weeks away.
A little more than 2 weeks.
Yeah. So we're waiting for that. Now you, so you were here, you started the 2013 right before the week before the launch of Xbox
One. 2 weeks before launch. So this would have been somewhere, there's someone at Microsoft that's going to start on Monday. It's going to be their first day, and I will know where they're at because
it's also very different because we were traveling to New York to do a launch, and it's, you know, this is true. Going to our virtual plus.
Immediately, my first day, you were like, okay, you got to book a flight to New York right now. And I was like, I don't know how to do that. And
look at you now.
Look at me. I'm not booking flights anywhere either. I miss New York. I haven't been in New York in years now. Oh, years, Larry.
I miss New York so much. I mean, you and I we've had a lot of good times. We've had a lot of good times everywhere.
Had a lot of good sandwiches in New York. You know how long it's been since I've had a proper pastrami sandwich?
That's the problem. Like, I can't find pickles. One around here in Seattle.
There is a place that's pretty good. It's not on the level, you know, of like Cantor's in L.A. or, you know, I'm trying to think of the name of the really awesome place in New York on
Katz's.
Katz's, thank you. Yeah, Katz's on Halston Street, East Halston.
How could you forget Katz's?
How can I forget? I'm allergic to cats. I don't know, but yeah, I miss Katz's. It's been too long.
Couple things.
We got to stop doing this podcast recording before lunch. We just end up talking about food.
Hey, should we stop and do you did an interview with someone from the coalition. Should we stop and do that? And maybe we'll talk about that. So let me key you up. Let me key you up for furniture. Oh, so Jeff had a chance. Gears Tactics is coming to Xbox Series X and S. It's enhanced. It's coming to console. They've done some really great work with it. And Jeff had a chance to talk to somebody from the coalition about it. We're going to show you some gameplay. Jeff's going to go deep. So take a look.
We are living in a golden age of turn-based strategy games right now. We're talking XCOM and Phoenix Point, Wasteland 3, and Mutant Year Zero, even Mario Rabbids. Totally great game. And I got to say, I love it. But this year, we had a new entrant into the world of strategy, and a very familiar one, the world of Gears of War with Gears Tactics. And that, guess what? That game is now coming to Xbox consoles on November 10th. So now I would love to introduce from the coalition, Tyler Bielman. Tyler, how you doing?
Hey, Jeff, how's it going? Great. Fantastic.
I love turn-based strategy games. I'm doing great. This is, like I said, a golden age. And I got to say, I played through Gears Tactics on PC this spring. Definitely in my top five favorite games of the year. Really super enjoyed it. But why don't we talk about, for those who maybe didn't get a chance to play it, that don't have a gaming PC and are looking forward to playing a new Gears experience on their console next month. How do you mix Gears and Tactics and have it come out like feeling so natural?
Yeah, we're super excited with the response that we got on PC, and I'm thrilled that the console players will get their hands on it November 10th alongside the release of the new hardware. But also the game, of course, will be available on Xbox One as well. When we set out to do this, it was very important to me that we bring the intensity and the style of Gears of War and mesh that with a turn-based game. And it wasn't clear from the beginning that we could do it. We had to do a lot of prototyping and some initial, even paper prototyping, like made a little board game out of it. And one of my key goals was to make sure that it was fast. As a strategy player, I'm always frustrated with how much downtime there were in these games. And so it was really important to me that we speed it up. We wanted to tell a really interesting and personal sort of story, because a lot of turn-based games have a more abstracted narrative. And we felt like if we could land those things, it would feel like Gears, along with some signature moments like the chainsaw and the executions and stuff. But we felt like if we could really speed it up, add a cool story that made sense in the universe, we could really make the Gears combat come to life in a turn-based way. There is a very tactical game at the center of Gears combat, the core sort of console game that people play, the third person over the shoulder cover based combat, is really at its core a tactical experience. And so we were able to break that down and reconstruct it in a turn based way. Here, yeah, you're seeing, I thought was really, so it's a little game footage.
I think something that as a longtime Gears fan whose reflexes on the Nasher are maybe not as fast as it used to be, I kind of really enjoyed the ability to see Gears from a new perspective. But the story really jumped out at me. There was, when interesting things happen, whether it's a lancer to the face of an enemy or, fully like voiced and modeled cutscenes, it really does get up close. And there was even like a moment in the story that I gasped. And so I feel like this was a real differentiator between a lot of turn-based strategy games, even games that I love. Story really comes second, if at all.
Yeah, we, to be Gears, we really wanted to make sure that the hero felt like a Gears hero, but also it's sort of a new and thoughtful hero for Gears. Gabe is an interesting character with his own backstory. He finds these new partnerships with Sid and Michaela along the way on his journey. It was also really important for us to feel like a Gears game, to have a big bad. So the antagonist, Ukon, is a key figure in Locust history. He's the monster that makes the monsters. He's responsible for Brumax and Corpsers. So there's a really important antagonist, Gabe's connection being the father of Kate, who's the protagonist in Gears 5. And the story itself has a lot to do with where the Locusts come from. That is sort of a big component of the plot. So we wanted to tell that kind of Gears story. We wanted to do it with AAA cinematics. So when you sit down and play, you're sort of blown away by the story that accompanies this sort of deep strategy experience.
Yeah, it even ties into events that are fresh in your mind after playing Gears 5, which I thought was a really nice touch. So let's talk about the game coming from PC into consoles. There's so many differences between console gaming and PC gaming, how close you sit to the screen, your input method. So can you talk about how you're adapting Gears Tactics to work great on Xbox consoles?
Yeah, from the beginning, we wanted to make a game that felt incredibly satisfying on PC with a keyboard and mouse. And we knew that to take that and bring it to the console, we needed extra time. So we took the extra time to release in a different window, and we spent those intervening months focused on a couple of key areas. The first one, which you mentioned, is the controls. It has to feel fantastic with the sticks in your hand, and we did it. We basically threw out the control scheme entirely and rebuilt it from the ground up for the controller. So as you're playing with a controller, whether that be on PC or on your console, we've added a suite of different controls that you might not have on the keyboard and mouse. So for example, on the left trigger, we have a precision targeting mode so that it will slow down the reticle so you could put it exactly where you want it on the screen. Because Gears Tactics doesn't have a grid, which also makes it different from other tactics games, it's really important that you be able to put that grenade exactly where you want it, or put that area of effect right where you want it. And on a big screen with sticks, it can feel a little sloppy. So we allow you to at will slow that down. You can also go right into the settings and change the degree of the speed of that mode. On the right trigger, we've got a zoom, so you can zoom into the battlefield nice and tight to see exactly what's going on, put things where you want it. We did a variety of things with ability selection, so it's easier to pick your weapon, easier to pick your abilities. When you pick certain contextual abilities like an execute or reviving, we snap the cursor right to the unit so that you don't have to move there with your stick. So we did a ton of things around the controls to make sure it feels awesome. We also refactored the front end and the convoy where you customize your units and where you choose your missions to make sure that that worked really easily and quickly with the controller. We also improved that for the keyboard and mouse players as well. And it's also worth noting that if you want to play with keyboard and mouse, you can plug a keyboard and mouse into your console and play that way, and you'll get the right interface for that input method, or you can put a controller into your PC and you'll get the control scheme for that. So, you know, the game is about giving you a lot of freedom, a lot of flexibility in the way you want to play, the way you want to win. And now you can play on whatever screen you want with whatever controls you want. So we're super happy with the controls. I mentioned the UI, which we're seeing here, like we've updated that to work better with controls. And then the third and final thing was just, you know, we added a lot more content. So whether you've finished the game on PC or you're coming to it brand new on the console, there's a whole new mode of campaign where you get Jack, who we're seeing here. And Jack is an incredible addition to the game. Jack goes with you on every mission and really changes and amplifies the powers of your squad. So lots of cool stuff coming with the November 10th version of the game.
Yeah, let's talk about that. I played through the entire game this spring. Again, a top fiver for me this year for sure. And I love that as someone who, you know, it has that game save on PC. I know that transfers over to console, which is really cool. But there's more than just Jack. There's like a whole separate mode with achievements, and then even some new enemies. And what's this about Supreme Weapons? Is this like a new streetwear brand?
Yeah, I'll give you kind of the lowdown. So, you know, we knew that we wanted to give people another reason to come back, as well as something exciting if you've never played before. And Jack was the biggest solution. We couldn't just add a few new skills or a couple of superficial things. We wanted to add something spectacular. And Jack brings a whole host of abilities to the battlefield. Notably, he has a set of capsule abilities, we call them. So he can create areas of effect on the board that will debuff your enemies or create more firing opportunities for you. He has a really cool ability called Hijack, where you can take control of an enemy for a limited period of time. They get added to your squad. You can control them, use their weapons, which is awesome. He has a series of auras and buffs that make your team better. All of that combines up to really amplify the way that you want to win and the squad you want to build. So Jack is the player side, the toy that you get. Well, to counter that, we brought in a new set of enemies called the Deviant enemies. And Deviants are stronger, tougher variants. They're kind of like captains of the enemy squads. Each of them has a unique skill that the enemies haven't had before. So for example, there's an alpha wretch, and the Deviant wretch has a pack ability that makes all the other wretches harder to hit. Played, you know, if those wretches get in close, they will knock you out of cover and then the drones will shoot you. Well, if you see that Deviant wretch on the battlefield, you have to really change your targeting priorities. So there's five different Deviant enemies that each have the unique skills and create a more dynamic encounter for the game. And then last but not least is Supreme equipment. We can't challenge you without giving you some rewards. So towards the back half of the game, we've added a power level, a tier of weapons. Oh, there's a Deviant getting executed right there. We've added a tier of weapons called Supreme. They're weapon mods, and we've added one for each mod slot for each class weapon. So, for example, with the long shot that goes with the sniper class, if you collect all four Supreme weapon mods for that long shot, it really turns that weapon into a crit machine. Your crits will be devastating. You will get lots of abilities that will process when you hit a crit. So it's kind of like the ultimate version of the weapon if you collect it. Oh, there's our Deviant Disciple.
Who I don't will want throw to out mess with him.
Poisonous mines. No, he's really bad. He's, and the mines that he throws out, again, sort of counters your ability with Jack to put out areas of effect. So lots of fun new challenges. Lots of fun new tools with Jack and the Supreme equipment. So we're really excited. We can't wait for everybody to get their hands on it and play. And all of this content, again, is available for every version of the game that's out there. So.
This is great. I'm definitely going to be new game plusing it. I'm just looking at that stuff and I'm thinking about
Yeah.
how Jack will help out in those missions where you need to send part of your party one direction and part in the other. Well, you know,
Yeah.
maybe this,
You're
Jack
totally
might
right.
see
And
like fail now.
Jack can open rescue pods, Jack can pick up equipment cases. So some of those errands that you would used to have to send a soldier that might you might rather shoot with that soldier or push a flank. Now you can use Jack for a bit of those things. And Jack can also has a cloak. So he if you know you can get him into some spaces and cloak him, and then he won't necessarily take fire because he turns invisible, as we see here. Now that's a temporary effect, so you got to be very tactical with it, and it costs an action like everything else, so it's not a freebie, but it will help you and allow you to use Jax for those sort of flexible battlefield conditions. One of
Oh,
Jax's other sort of first level. Oh, yeah, go ahead.
I was just going to ask. So Jack doesn't take the place of a squad member. It's looking like he
No,
joins
Jack,
the four.
every mission after he gets added, I believe in Act One, Chapter Three, and any point after that, he's automatically on missions. He's a constant companion on the battlefield. So you don't have to trade off. We didn't want to force you to trade off offensive capability for Jack. We want Jack to be an addition and a buff to your squad all the time. And speaking of buffs, Jack has an ability called Wingman. Wingman is one of his early abilities, and that is a stackable buff that allows you to improve the accuracy and damage of one of your other units. So there's always something for Jack to be doing that can advance your battle plan.
This is very cool. I'm just loving what I'm seeing here because that's that for those who have played through the game, like that adds a tremendous extra dimension to the game. And I'm sure as we start to see these deviant enemies, I'm sure they're really hard and you will
You'll need
need
it.
Jack to
Yeah.
succeed. Yeah.
Yeah, you will. Yeah,
This game
it's
is
exciting.
so Gears Tactics is debuting on console on the launch day for Xbox Series X and Series S. What's it like working on next gen console, next gen hardware, and what were you able to do with it that maybe you wouldn't have been able to do previously?
Yeah, it's an incredible opportunity to put out a console exclusive on a launch day, and we were really excited that we were able to you know, it didn't affect our development. It sort of lined up perfectly, serendipity-wise, that our console release could be day and date with the new hardware. Our engineering team, you know, has been able to leverage the power of the console to not only make sure that just the visuals are more spectacular, coming from a PC game. Where you know you sort of have ultra high specs, you know we're able to target exactly the Xbox Series S and the Xbox Series X hardware specs so that you get the best version of the game for that hardware. Additionally, just with the speed that you get from the new hardware, it actually fits perfectly with one of our goals for the game, which is to make a faster, more intense experience. So, the enemy turn calculations, the amount of time that the enemy takes to use their turns, how fast you can get from cutscenes in the game, all of that sort of loading and processing time is reduced dramatically. So it's a very seamless experience on that hardware, which is one of the goals we had from the absolute beginning, before we really even knew that new hardware was coming 4 or 5 years ago when we started the process of making Gears Tactics. So it's great.
All right, last question here for you, Tyler. This is maybe a core
Sure.
question here, but do you have
Yeah.
a favorite ability in the game? Like, because when you're building out your skill trees, this is not a game where you're going to be filling out the entire tree. You have to make some really tough decisions on how you're going to be spending those points. So, what's like a must-have ability that you want to make sure, this is what you need to be doing?
Yeah, I think I'll fall back to something I mentioned earlier. If you're not going towards hijack in the skill tree for Jack, then you're missing out on an incredible opportunity because being able to temporarily take control of an enemy unit, push them up into the center of the enemies, use them to destroy enemies, and then make sure that they get taken out before they go back to the enemy team is great. And that is a portion of the skill tree that's very exciting for Jack. I'm also personally a fan of the execution mechanic in the game. One of the ways that our game feels really intense and lets you keep moving forward is if you pull off an execution, we give the rest of your squad an extra action. So anytime you can get that execution, it's really important. So the scout is sort of the execution master. So there are lots of places in the skill tree. Anything that says execution as a skill, you should definitely take a look at it and prioritize it. And the supreme equipment for the scout is all execution based too, just as a quickie. So that turns that scout into an action generating machine.
Yeah,
So I
that's a
didn't
really
give you
good
one,
point. I
but
think,
there's an overview.
yeah, that's fine. These are good. I didn't even realize Jack was going to have its own skill tree. So that's a great piece of
Oh
info.
yeah,
And
Jack
I
has
think
a
if,
full, yeah.
go on, go on.
Oh yeah, he's got a full unique skill tree of his own skills, unlike anything else in any of the other classes. So plenty to explore there. And every once in a while, we give you a skill reset token that allows you to go ahead and respec. So while you can't fill out the whole tree at any point, you have lots of opportunities to try a different build if you want to by spending the tokens. And then when you beat the campaign and you get into veteran mode, we call it, where we're just sort of giving you a lot of different a variety of missions, we let you respec for free any unit you want, so you can just keep trying different builds and different combinations with different weapon mods. So once you reach veteran mode, the game is really open to you to play the way you want.
All right, Tyler
There's
Bielman,
Jack's
thank you
skill
so
tree
much.
right there. We just saw.
That's
Yeah,
awesome. That's
absolutely.
good
Yeah,
timing.
Jeff, I appreciate it. Yeah, we couldn't be more thrilled. Like everybody, we just can't wait for people to play.
And they don't have to wait too long because Gears Tactics is coming to consoles on November 10th, and that new content is coming to PC on the same day. And if you're a Gears fan who thought, I've never really played strategy, strategy might not be for me, it's part of Xbox Game Pass. I'm telling you, from a
Absolutely.
veteran in this genre, this is not a sit back and patient and wait for things to come to you. You are constantly driving forward as the most offensive-minded, yet really intelligent and strategic strategy game that I've ever played. And I really enjoy the way it captures that Gears feeling, even though it's not something that is totally reflex-based. So, and by the way, if you do play the game with Game Pass before December 4th, you get an old friend, Cole. Thrashball Cole is a playable character
Thrashball
that you'll be
Cole.
able to put in the game, and he's fully voiced, which is great. So you get to hear him, woo, and like a lot of the other, things you would expect Cole to say. You get to hear him through the game, so you'll want to play that. And November 10th is the date. So thanks so much, Tyler.
Absolutely. It was a pleasure, Jeff, and thank you for the kind words. The team couldn't be more excited, so thanks a lot.
Me too. Thank you.
There you go, Gears Tactics, Jeff. Great job on that interview. I know you played
Yeah.
you mentioned that during the interview. You played the game, you finished the game, and now you're going to go back and play it again.
When we wrapped up the interview, Tyler was like, you did mean those things, right? And I was like, you're
Yeah.
being very nice. He was like, you're being very nice. I was like, check my achievements. I love this game. It's absolutely one of my top five favorite games this year.
Legit.
Yeah, so that's great.
We got some news we got to talk about, right?
We always do, Larry.
We
We
always do.
always do.
We've got a bunch of stuff going on here. We've got well, actually, we should talk about the
The
Xbox
app?
app. Should we talk
Yeah.
about that? Yeah, let's go
Go
ahead and
for
do
it. Yeah.
that. We've got for those of you who don't know, for Android and iOS, we have an app now that let me I'm gonna see if I can open it up here on my phone, that it's been updated and it's got a bunch of really cool new stuff in it, in that you can it's much easier to social share some of your screenshots on social. You can kind of see what's going on. There's Jeff on the bottom there.
Hey, look at me.
Could take a look at that. What do you say? It says you're calling Call of Duty Black
Cowboy,
Ops, man.
yeah, man. It works.
You can also, you've got all your captures in here, so you can kind of take a look at that. You can share them on social. Let me show you this one. This is one from Apex Legends. So you can like, oh, okay, let me do that. And you click share. I mean, it's worth it. You'll get the update. You can also do some stuff with your console. And that's better managing your console. You can delete things off your console. So when you remote download, you can kind of do some storage
Reconfiguring.
management, as it were.
Yeah.
So,
You know where it's best, and if you're
do
planning
tell.
on getting a new
Do tell.
console, if you're getting a Series X or a Series S this holiday, don't make sure you download it because it allows you to have like a streamlined setup process. This is when you first get your Xbox Series X, Series S, and you plug it in, it's going to take the newest update.
Just like
I will tell
any
you
modern electronic connected device.
anything yet. I will say it's a significantly faster and smoother process than in the past, but especially if you use the app to set it up. We've been testing this out, and basically having to like type in your password with the controller, especially if you've got like a safe long password, you should be using long passwords with two-factor authentication and all that stuff. If you do it through the phone, you're like, you're done. And it walks you through all the setup. And then even the questions that while it's downloading that update, it'll ask you about your power saving. Do you want to have that mode on? Who do you want to have signed in? All that type of stuff. You can go through that process, be more efficient, get through that process, put it in the rear view, and start playing right away.
Yeah, so what you're going to want to do is you get the app here, and in the upper right-hand corner, you can kind of see this over here. There's a little icon next to the bell. You can see your consoles and just click Setup Console. If you have one already set up, you can go through it, but you can click Setup New Console, and it's going to kind of walk you through. You kind of see the, unfortunately, the reflection.
The glare.
Yeah. But it's going to kind of go through, add an existing console, set up a new console, go through it. And as Jeff said, you're going to put in your password. Hey, is this you? Do you want to do, energy saving or, quick resume, and set all those up? And then you'll
it's over before you know it.
And then what you can do is you let it go, and you can go in the other room and get a sandwich or whatever. And if you bring your phone with you, it'll pop up and say,
"Do you really just do the sandwich thing, Larry?" Bringing those back like 12 years on that one.
And then, yes.
You don't always have enough time, depending on your internet, to make a sandwich, I can tell you that.
And I'm telling you, these consoles reboot fast.
Yeah. You were seeing me do that where, right before we started recording, that fuse lost power because we were having a lightning storm, and you could see it reboot, and it was like, that was fast. I can't wait for y'all to have that, to feel that speed. It has to be felt.
Feel the speed. Anyway, let's go. We're continuing on with the news, Jeffrey.
Yeah, well, let's even start. So coming this week, we always Game Pass, the gift that keeps on giving. And coming soon to Xbox Game Pass for console and streamable via Android devices, Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six Siege. This is a game that tens of millions of people play. It's made by Ubisoft, and it is like one of the most popular esports. And they've added so much. The game has been out. When did it first come out? 2016, maybe. I remember us playing when it first came out, and it has really they've put so much into it. There's new content. It's evolved. The meta has changed repeatedly. It's there's always some great stuff to like on ramp for it. And if you're just now playing for the first time through Xbox Game Pass, you can feel safe and secure that many other people are just now starting. And so it is a good time to join, and you will not be the only you won't be only just picked on by people who've been playing for years.
Yep.
Doom Eternal, another Xbox Game Pass new entrant. Let's say you've somehow gone through and you've already beaten the campaign. Well, there is new content here. The Ancient Gods Part 1. That is an additional purchase, but if you've already got the game, then it is actually also currently on sale, actually, now that I'm looking, for $17.99 here in this initial launch period.
Yeah.
More Bethesda news here. Ah. Fallout 76 is celebrating its bombs drop day.
The headlines are a little bit ahead of you scrolling along the bottom here, if you've noticed.
Are they? I'm reading it off of the blog. But free play week, there's sales, there's in-game events. So up until October 26, all Xbox Live Gold members get to hop into Fallout 76 and play the game for free. This is another game that has seen significant support post-launch and updates, and the game is not where it was when it started. It's much further along and much better. There's just a lot. There's a ton of new content. They've added really just a whole lot of stuff into this. So there's also a lot of other Fallout stuff that is on sale, like the Fallout 4 Game of the Year edition is 70% off. The original edition, 70% off. Season Pass is 60% off. So there's just a ton there if you want to traipse around post-apocalyptic Boston and you hadn't done that yet.
I love that.
I know.
What did you name your character?
Oh my God. I'd have to look.
Only reason I know is because when I did the interview with Phil and Todd and Pete, I had my Fallout Pip-Boy up on the screen, and I didn't know, nobody noticed my, I don't know, maybe you couldn't read it, but at the bottom, I was like, when I'm making my character, I named her Barbara, but instead of Barbara, it was Babra. Because you're in Boston.
Babra. Mine might have been Hobbit Yacht or something. I don't recall. It's just, it's where you park the car. So another PC. We've been talking about for some time now on Xbox Wire. We have a recurring feature.
Wait a minute.
Feature.
It's meta. The podcast is in the news section. I'm just looking at the scroll on the bottom.
We've come full circle here.
Wow,
so inside we have a series called Inside Xbox Series X Optimized. Yeah. So for these 30 titles that we talked about that will be optimized on day one, what are they doing to optimize? How are they taking advantage of the velocity architecture of
what
all
are
this,
they doing?
You know, video RAM and all this the 12 teraflops and everything else that they're doing, dynamic refresh rates and everything else. Well, this is where we give the developers a chance to tell you. So we have a new one up there for Yakuza Like a Dragon. And the reason I call this out is one,
I
always like hearing from this team. And I'm a Yakuza fan. They released a really great trailer. It's like 1 minute that sort of talks about optimizations. It's very tongue-in-cheek. It's very funny. And it's not a dry, technical chat.
Can you send me that link and I'll put it in the show notes?
Oh, yeah, for sure. I'll put that aside. But yeah, you have to watch the trailer. It's very funny. We also heard from the team at Ubisoft about Assassin's Creed Valhalla. Actually, Will Tuttle, who's our editor and friend at Xbox Wire, if we were in the office, we'd all be sitting together. Let's not go too far. He got to play 6 hours of Assassin's Creed Valhalla a couple days ago.
Which, if it's anything like any Assassin's Creed, it's like that much.
Barely did anything.
Right.
But what he did is, and I really like the angle he took. They've really changed the way like the map looks, like where there'd usually just be like a bunch of stuff, but you're like, okay, I got to collect these and this is a side mission, all that. There's a bunch of different things called like mysteries. There's 11 different types of them. And so he went through all 11 of these different types of modes. He tried them all and he wrote about them and what they are. And a lot of these are just like some of them are puzzles. Some of them
forever.
are 6 hours, apparently. Some of them sound actually like a lot of the sort of sub stories that you would play in Yakuza, where it's a serious story, but then there's like something ridiculous there where you end up being in a video game or a music video, or they get really strange. So there are stuff like that offer some levity into the game. There's sort of tough optional boss battles. And when you do certain things, you get like really cool weapons or points to put into your skill tree. There's just a lot of interesting stuff here to take on. There's apparently one that where you go get into medieval rap battles. Sure. Sounds good.
Why not?
Why not? So it's an article worth checking out. And then there's going to be something that we started to see at first in, I think the first time we saw this was in Odyssey, or might have been even in the DLC for Origins, where you start to see some sort of mystical animals or beasts, legendary beasts.
Yeah, the legendary
and
beasts.
Apparently, one of them, this like large shaggy wolf called the Black Shuck, that is like a legend of English history, is in it, or Fenrir rather. So anyway, there's apparently some like animals to take down and beasts to take down. So, and there's a skill shot, a screenshot. This is going to be a lot to do. It's going to be a lot to do. And I'm looking forward to it. And just the videos I've seen, this game looks beautiful.
Well, this also gets back to what we were saying before we started recording, is not just a lot to do in the game, but there's a lot of games coming out.
There's an awful lot of games.
Think about all the backlog you already have and bringing that forward to Xbox Series X and S. And then all the new games are going to be optimized. I mean, you've got... It's quite a bounty, I shall say.
Takes discipline. I felt good about my backlog reduction plan that I've been undertaking all summer. So I am ready for the first fall game holiday game, I think, is Watch Dogs Legion. Like, if you don't count like FIFA and sort of the recurring games, based.
You've got the backlog reduction plan. Are we doing anything about the facial hair reduction plan?
No.
Okay. Yeah, I noticed
that. We're not going to do that. Okay. Anyway, so coming up on Halloween, look, I don't know how Halloween is going to play out. I have a feeling it's not going to be the most fun Halloween.
Are you going to have people banging
on your door? Perspective. So we usually go out. I have an 11-year-old daughter, and so we usually trick or treat. And
what's the plan
this year? I don't think we are. Okay. We're just trying to gauge. Certainly, we haven't done any work on a costume. So we're just sort of trying to gauge like what's going on. We may walk around the neighborhood. Some of the houses like super get into it and they are doing that. So we may walk around and, you know, maybe I'll buy her some candy or something like that. But I just don't know that, you know, a crowd of kids lined up at the door of a stranger's house is necessarily the smartest thing to do.
Well, I've always said that, even not in COVID, I've always said that. So I was right, Jeff. Just say it.
Maybe. I mean, we've never had an issue previously.
We're
but,
doing over here in the suburbs. We've got a little in our neighborhood. My wife and daughter are making little bags for each child, and we're going to deliver them the day of Halloween.
Oh, well, that's nice.
Right. So
that's
that
nice. You have my address.
Yeah. Oh, I do. I drop by frequently, randomly on a weekend. You'll just see me.
It does happen. Yeah.
Jeff, are you there? Hello. Yeah. Hello. anyway.
I the drop-in, it's a dying art. So anyways, that being
I'm bringing
said,
it back.
Trick or treat. It's maybe it never died. While Halloween may not be like your traditional Halloween, a lot of games are getting into the act. They do typically. We've seen this with Apex. We've seen this with Call of Duty, Modern Warfare. Actually, I played that mode last night, the sort of zombie mode where when you die, you come back as a zombie and you it's good. It's really
it's fun.
A couple other games just wanted to call out. Fortnite is doing something called Fort Nightmares.
Yep.
Midas's Revenge. And there's like some cool looking skins. And there's even some stuff with like musicians, like J Balvin is doing like a performance, who's a four-time Latin Grammy winner. And so he's going to be debuting a song. Like it's sort of like a Halloween party, like a virtual Halloween party. I think that's really cool. Rocket League is doing their haunted Halloween and it is with the Ghostbusters. So I think that's really cool. There's a Slimer car and a Stay Puft Marshmallow Man car. And of course the Ecto-1 is in the game. And so just, you know, be safe this Halloween and maybe, you know, eat the candy yourself and play some Halloween spooky video games. I think that's probably
be safe. That's the most important.
Last thing is, it's getting pretty cold, Larry. It's going to be in the 30s tonight, which
we're supposed to get snow in Seattle this week,
which is crazy. But it is getting cold. I haven't turned on the heat yet. However, there is a cuddle up and get and cozy game sale on ID at Xbox for some cozy games, games that sort of make you feel good. A couple of examples here: Ooblets, Golf with Your Friends. I know you like that one. Slime Rancher. Sort of games to like kind of chill out. These games are on sale. Ooblets is 20% off. Totally Reliable Delivery Service. My daughter and I had a fun time with that one at 30% off. Slime Rancher.
For some reason, I was bummed it wasn't tied into Kiki's Delivery Service.
Yes.
right? I was like, is this? Oh, no, it's not.
There's not a Kiki's Delivery Service game, is there?
There isn't. It feels like there's a missed opportunity you would, there.
Slime Rancher is 65% off. Laura was a big fan of that game, as I recall.
Yep.
There's a few other ones that are just kind of just chill, cozy games. And that sale goes on until October 26th.
Head over to my blog at majornelson.com and that will give you all the details. We'll get all the sales. We'll keep you completely cut in over there. So
What we do. What's more to say other than I really want a pastrami sandwich right now and I can't have it. And I'm not coping well with it, Larry.
Hey, I got a lot to talk about in the next coming weeks. We've got I'll be talking to the guys from LG about the OLED, which I've been using, which is phenomenal for gaming.
Life's good.
Life is good. I actually upgraded. You haven't noticed, Jeffrey, but there's an upgrade that you may or may not notice in the screen, which I'm really excited
about. It looks like you have like a new hinge or like a mic stand. It looks like cybernetic. Is that always been there? Did I get it wrong?
No, I'm talking about, and I don't know if I'm going to be able to show it, but I've upgraded my chair, and you can't really see too much.
Oh, I know which one this is.
This is the guys at Herman Miller.
The thing. Can you turn it around? Because it looks like the Dead Space armor. It looks like Isaac's armor in the back.
Let me move my microphone so you can kind of see. You can't really see it. Here, let me
lift it up. You're strong. Look at that. Doesn't that look like Isaac? This is your health bar up the middle.
Right.
How much oxygen you have left.
So yeah, we're going to talk about, let me bring my microphone back here. We'll talk to those guys. I'm going to have a seating expert on from Herman Miller. And this is a company that you may or may not be aware of. They make some of the greatest chairs and some furniture, very stylish. But I'm going to have them on to talk about, how do they make a great gaming chair? What do they do? I mean, we've seen so many people in this space, but what can they do different? And you would be surprised at what they're able to do. So we're going to talk about
that. How do you feel? Later. How's your back feel right now, Larry?
Well, what's interesting is it doesn't have the kind of rest. And they're very clear in their FAQ on their site. Like, hey, we don't need it because it just feels so good.
Well, the traditional Herman Miller chair doesn't go up that high either. It's not like a throne.
Yeah. Yeah. So, but we'll talk to those guys. I'm really excited. I've never talked to somebody from a chair designer. I mean, I don't even know what that is. Let's talk about that. Stay tuned.
I don't know. A lot of sitting happens. We won't talk about my standing desk.
Yeah, that's right. Totally. We both have standing desks, and I tend to see you sitting more than standing. And likewise, I tend to do the same thing.
It's for the angles. They're like a huge mess. Yeah. So I sit during the show. Otherwise, if I'm standing, I'll walk around.
Anyway, well, listen, we'll let you go. We muddled through this week. We did it again, Jeffrey.
Wow. You said it was going to be a great show.
And congratulations to you, dear listener. You've wasted another hour.
Oh, man. It's not another hour closer to Xbox Series X launch. And, I do want to thank our guest, Tyler Bielman. That, I think, was the best part of the show.
Great. Tyler was great.
And Gears Tactics coming out November 10th for console. And then a huge update for PC. And, of course, Xbox Game Pass. So you've got many ways to acquire it.
If you have any questions, you know how to find us. You can find me on social at Major Nelson, of course. You can find Jeffrey right over there. You can see at Jeff Rubenstein. That's the complaint desk.
Always let me have them, and you know what people do. And if sometimes need, if you, I, you, I can't help.
If you need any tips for bubble tea, that's the guy.
No, there's some good ones. There's some really good. Oh, I had a pumpkin spice one this weekend with cheese foam.
I saw. Sounds gross. I was at Costco the other day, and they had pumpkin spice dip. No, I couldn't push my cart past fast. I was like, no, run away.
Certain things should be pumpkin spiced. Certain things, most things, I would venture should not be.
Yes.
But when it's done, a beverage, pumpkin spice, a beverage, maybe a muffin.
All right. We're talking about food, which means it's time for us to break.
Hey, so, I have to go. I'm hungry.
All right, gang. We'll talk to you guys next week, Jeff. If you have time to join us next week, I'd love to have you back.
I would love to be here.
And for everybody else out there, stay safe. Have fun. Listen, just a little bit, about 2 weeks left before Xbox Series X and S launch. So we're looking forward to that. Also, make sure you follow me on Twitter at Major Nelson. I'll have all the details. I got some free Code Friday stuff. I may be giving away a console soon, so a real console, not one of the just the plastic shells.
Not that, that goes to your neighbors.
This isn't eBay where you're bidding on a shell, right? You're getting the real deal. So. All right, gang. We'll talk to you guys next time. Bye, bye, everybody.